Hello and greetings from Iceland. This video is a direct continuation of my last update about the fight to protect the critical infrastructure. And as we expected, we are still in control of this situation. And let's start with the power line that got cut off from the main grid as the ground clearance under the power line decreased due to this new 8-meter thick lava layer beneath the pylons, and that was just too much. So one of the tallest pylons in the country was assembled there in order to connect the power plant again to the main grid. And not all know that what we have there is a hybrid power plant that not only produces hot water, but electricity as well. So the main grid, it should be at full capacity soon, although the lava will still be crawling under the power line, but hopefully not high enough to cause more damage. And as for the lava berms, or this remarkable rescue operation that is still ongoing, that project goes well. They work now on 8-hour shifts with 25 trucks that are adding somewhere around 8,000 cubic meters to the berms every day. First they make them wider and then they build them upwards. And this water cooling makes this thick crust around this river of lava under it. So the lava itself will be the foundation for this new addition to the lava berms. And what we have now is a similar problem as we had in June when this clip was shot. The crust it tends to give in and then we get splashes like this. So this is what the next days will be about. Or fight those little pockets of lava that might open up and flow over the lava berms. And the eruption is not powering down as fast as we expected. Like we have seen very little changes during the last 24 hours. Scientists can not yet confirm if the lava inflow to the magma chamber that is feeding this eruption is coming to an end. It seems as it's continuing as for the most recent data, but they are saying that they need several more days to collect data to see if the build-up to eruption number 11 has already started. But the main question of the day is when will this eruption be over and done with? Or are we about to see something like the eruption that started on the 16th of March? I filmed that one quite well and I was still flying up to the crater on May 5th and I think the eruption was over 1 or 2 days after that. And that eruption started with only a 3 kilometer long fissure like the eruption that we are dealing with now. So it was one of the shorter fissures, but it took longer time. And given how steady this remaining crater has been the last 24 hours, I think it's still a chance that this eruption might be a part of the Christmas lights by the Blue Lagoon. And most of the lava is flowing eastward right now, away from the Blue Lagoon, but it cannot be ruled out that some of it is flowing westward under the solidified surface. And I heard a new theory yesterday, or why the lava has not flowed into the Blue Lagoon. And this all Icelandic theory says that it simply cannot afford it due to the ticket price. So this is just a little sample of Icelandic sarcasm as we celebrate the opening of the Blue Lagoon next Friday, November 29th. And if that works out, it would not be for the first time that they open up the lagoon before the eruption stops. Like I was filming by the Blue Lagoon with this background last summer, still 2 active craters back then, but the last remaining crater this time is further north, so this is not the tourist view that they will get now, or the Christmas view, or this excellent reason to ask for a discount from the ticket price, because they are not offering the full show right now. And it is good news that the village Grindavík opened up again for guests yesterday. No restrictions, only the areas that are considered to be dangerous, and there are fences that keep people out from them, and sometimes the idiots inside them. But this time, both the roads to the Blue Lagoon went under lava, and quite a bit of it this time, so it's going to be more tricky than usual to make new roads on top of the lava, and this is new lava, and we usually don't make roads on new lava until it is 1 or 2 weeks old. It needs some time to cool down. And I do actually have a video online that I'm linking to, where you can see one of the old versions of the Blue Lagoon road with a thermal camera after it was remade on top of hot lava. But the road you see in that video, it is gone under lava now. And also the road that is built on top of that road. And this ongoing eruption came with the fourth layer, so we can't even see now where the old roads were. So this is quite a task. But on the bright side, after we park our cars there for a while, the tires will get excellent grip for the icy roads of Iceland. And one of the problems we face now is how will the Blue Lagoon fix the car park problem with 8 meter thick lava on top of it. And I was today reading about that there might be bus service from Grindavík since the town has reopened. And I actually think that parking in Grindavík will be the solution to get the lagoon going again. And this has been quite a journey through eruption number 10. And although the most dramatic bits of the story might soon be over, there are still plenty of details to cover. And as I've mentioned before, I have countless hours of footage and all my vlogs. And at some point in time, this will be made into a documentary. And it will for some part be about the irreversible landscape changes. And in my opinion, the most valuable part of my video collection is the footage that I shot before the November 10th event, before any lava berms or any eruption. And since the town is open now, I will be driving to the Reykjanes Peninsula in the morning. I've already filled the car with diesel and charged all batteries. And I will be taking my computer with me, so there won't be any delay in my upload schedule. That includes other projects as well. Since all this month until this eruption, I was working on important but time-consuming preparation work for several long videos. And recently, I've been working on a Christmas special, but low light conditions are the only conditions that I have plenty of these days. But I'm in the far north, and the days are getting extremely short because I'm only 80 kilometers away from the Arctic Circle. And as often during winters, there is no proper snow in Reykjavík or the Reykjanes Peninsula, which is quite dull, but useful when it comes to documenting the landscape changes. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.